Hello, everybody. My name is Michael Woodside, and I'm an animator. And today I'm going to teach you how to draw a Cheshire Cat. It's Cat Week, and I've got a lot of fun ones planned, so this is one of my favorites. I'm going to go ahead and start cleaning my hands before we start using our tools. You can actually see the tools that I'll be using here on the bottom of the screen. These are actually just some Crayola colored pencils I found in my desk. So they're not fancy art supplies. They're art supplies you can get anywhere. So I think that any colors that you have that sort of are a pinkish variety is what we're going to need, and then a yellow for the eyes. So I'm going to do my underdrawing with this red pencil and then go back over it with the black pencil. So first things first, I'm going to start doing some warm-up circles and talk about some helpful information. So some people might be wondering who this class is for, if you need to have drawing experience or be very good at drawing in order to do it. You really don't need any new experience. I'm going to teach people how to draw from line by line, so you can really pick it up as you go along. Cheshire Cat's a really fun, broad character to learn, so there are very few wrong lines. You can go wild with him. His animator was Ward Kimball, and he was one of Walt's nine old men, and he was sort of the zaniest out of all of the animators, so crazy personality, and so you can see that in a lot of his artwork. So halfway through this drawing, it might look weird and you might feel like you want to throw it away, and don't do that, because you want to make sure you make it to the end of the drawing. Drawings always look weird halfway through, and give yourself a chance to learn the whole drawing before you decide if it didn't work or not. As you see, when I'm doing these circles, I move my whole arm and I'm not just moving my fingers. And in doing that, that helps make sure that I'm getting full, even lines. And if I were just moving my hand or my fingers, it's a little more timid. Cheshire Cat has a lot of big shapes, so we want to practice with big lines. And it looks super sloppy right now, but if you've seen this class before, you know that one of the first things we do when we're done with our underdrawing is go back over with a darker line. And I love what that does, is that it sort of makes those red lines go away. And we can just focus on the lines that we wanted to see. And we're gonna start coloring in our character as well, so that's gonna make those go away even more. So for instance, if I just take this pencil and start coloring it in here, then really I'm sort of tricking the viewer to look at just the parts I want them to see. And we focus mostly just on that contrast there. So it's a good trick. I recommend it for everybody. What I'm going to start with then, typically our characters start with a circle, but for the Cheshire Cat, I kind of want to start with that gumdrop shape that we have drawn in the past. So the part of the Cheshire Cat we're going to be drawing today is just his head and his smile. So we're going to need the whole page for that. He's got a pretty wide smile, so I'm going to leave a little bit of room on top for the ears, but most of the space will be down here at the bottom. So for the gumdrop shape, it's sort of like a half circle. A little squished on top. So it looks like that. And I'm just going to flatten out here. And that's sort of where the bottom of his face is going to connect to him. But before we draw the bottom of the face, I want to pull out the ping pong ball that lets you know what direction our character is going to be looking. So I drew these lines on the ball to help illustrate that if the character is looking straight at us, then the lines would be perfectly vertical or horizontal. If they're turned in different directions, then you can see how the lines sort of bend. So when you see somebody draw those circles that have kind of these lines on them, and then they start building shapes on top of that, that's just a really quick way to immediately lay down which way your character is going to be facing, so that every choice you make after that is related to that perspective. So, for the Cheshire Cat, we're just going to have him looking straight at us. He's got that kind of crazy stare, so it's most effective, I think, when we're seeing it straight on. So, I'm just going to go right down the middle. We're only going to do the vertical line, because the bottom of his face is all down here, and the eyes are going to be pretty much right here. So, I'm just going to really roughly block in sort of like the capital letter D. And then what that will be is a really rough indication of what the cheeks are doing. So the D kind of connects on either side, and then it's turned this way. You can make the shape as big or as small as you like. It's gonna have a big, still a closed mouth smile, but it's a big one. So we wanna make sure we leave a lot of room for that. I'm gonna make mine a little darker on my page than you probably should, but I just wanna make sure that you're able to see it. See, doesn't that look like a cat? No. It looks so weird already. But we'll get there. Kind of looks like a little boat. Okay, so what we always try to do first is the nose, because the nose really gives us a bunch of information about how the shape is built. So actually, I'm gonna first continue this vertical line all the way down, because we're gonna need that. So the nose, it's sort of a, if you think of a triangle, it's like that, but it's rounded on all the different sides. So it's not a circle. It's like a rounded triangle there. It's actually, the triangle's a little wider than what I drew, so maybe it's more like that. Let's draw it on here. So I'm gonna make mine pretty wide. It's gonna go, highest point is gonna be right at that middle line. And it connects down into here. I'm gonna draw, actually, we'll just go ahead and do his nostrils. There are these ovals that are sort of turned sideways on either side of his nose. Okay, so let's go ahead and draw some swoopy lines that connect his head to his cheeks, and that'll give us a little bit more information that we need. So starting from near the top of the head, I'm just gonna draw, think of it like you're holding a piece of spaghetti that's connecting from here to here. It kind of droops in the middle. Do the same thing on the other side. Little droopy lines. I'll make mine droop a little bit more than that. Music makes it feel like something special is happening. Droopy lines. Okay, so the next thing I'd like to do is sort of show how we're gonna break off the bottom of the face from the top of the face. And now that we have the nose, we can do that. So I'm gonna draw some, again, some like kind of spaghetti noodle lines that go out to the side, just past the outside of our gumdrop. And then from here, I'm going to do a big rounded C shape that kind of overlaps that spaghetti line on this side. And it connects into the bottom of the D shape. So as artists, you're constantly kind of making adjustments to your drawing. Very rarely do you watch an artist who just does, that's a perfect line, and then does the next perfect line. You're constantly kind of changing it and making sense of it as they draw, because they're sort of finding the drawing as they go. And that has been my technique. And that also sort of takes the pressure off of doing something perfect at the beginning, because I never will. And so I want to make sure that I give myself a chance to learn. We do the same thing on the other side. Speaking of which, I'm gonna make the nose just a little bit bigger on my drawing. Let's move these nostrils down. Once we color it all in, you won't even see any of this. And that. Okay, so now we can do the mouth corners, and that'll let us know how wide the smile is going to be. And it's going to be all the way across. So I'm going to do these, you call them C shapes, but it's just like a rounded line on both sides. And while you do those, I'll talk about our shapes that we always draw. We do circles all the time. We do straight lines. We do C shapes, and then we call them reverse C shapes that go like a C that's pointed the other direction. And then we do S shapes. And a lot of times those S shapes are kind of stretched out. So these are great lines to practice over here. This is sort of our practice zone. Stretched out C shapes. It's just good things to learn. So now we're gonna do a really long C shape. That's gonna be the top lip that connects to the other, from one mouth corner to the other mouth corner. So I'm just going to kind of really roughly block that in. So Ward Kimball, who was the animator for Cheshire Cat, was also the animator for Tweedledee and Tweedledum. So you can see if he had a style, it was crazy fun animation. Kooky, weirdo characters. Of course, he's got a big open smile, so we want to draw that too. So I'm going to draw another C shape that is a little closer here than it is down here. So I'm just going to draw a line where I want it to open up to you. And then kind of connect that back into the mouth. See how it's a little, the lines are closer together here than they are here. It's a good way to show perspective. And then we want to draw the teeth lines. I'm going to do about 12 of them. So the first teeth line I want to put is right in the middle. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do that. And as I'm getting out to the side, the lines are a little more rounded. All teeth. 2. He's got a small bottom lip. We want to give him right here. He's also got a line that connects the front of the lip to the nose. So we want to kind of do that here. Pretty straight line. Now I want to give him 3 whiskers on either side. Little ones, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. And the fun little design thing is he's got little whisker dots in between all those, and then at the bottom. If I quickly my shape a little bit, just make it a little bit smaller in the chin. You see that none of the pencils I'm using have erasers. It's just sort of a sketchy drawing trying to work out the shapes. So see, I'm making the chin a little bit smaller now. Okay, so now we're gonna give him a pretty rough indication of what the hair is gonna look like. So I'm just gonna draw a big rounded line that goes out this way. And then this line that we drew, I'm just gonna have it kind of swoop up. And that's sort of our rough shape. We're gonna have hairs come off of that and do the same thing on the other side. And I'm noticing that this is about above the mouth corner, so I wanna make this go about that far away. I'm trying to keep the left and the right side the same. Of course it is the Cheshire Cat, so he can be a little kooky. Exactly the same. And he's got two little ears on top, and they're, if you think of a triangle that's been kind of pushed outward, that's what we have. So we have a rounded line like that, and then another rounded line over here. It's going to be behind the hair, so I'm going to have to finish it. Same on the other side. And I'm just gonna draw another little rounded line here to show that the ears are sort of perked up and pointed right at us. Kind of turn inward towards each other. So now we have those shapes, just gonna sort of start breaking out little lines, little hairs. And what they end up being is like, you take the letter V, turn it upside down, and then turn it over. So there's just a lot of shapes like that. They're all different sizes because it's hair. So you do these pretty quickly. As quickly as you're comfortable with. And there's kind of some separation too, because remember, he's kind of kooky. Same on the other side. And you want to do the hairs differently on either side, so they don't look like they're the same exact design. And then he has some hairs over here. That's why we drew this D shape really dark or really light, so that we could come over dark with other lines. And they just sort of come back into the cheek here that we already made. The last part we haven't drawn is the eyes. He's got these really wide open eyes, sort of characteristic of his design is his smile and his eyes. So we want to make sure we get those really clear. So we've drawn eyes before that are kind of circular or ovals. He's got a really interesting shape. They're squashed ovals, but they're squashed in different places. They're almost like squashed eggs, and I'll show you what I mean. It's rounded down here, and then it comes all the way up to the middle, and then it's a little more narrow on top. It comes back around. So you see how it looks a little bit like an egg that's just been pressed flat against the drawing. In the other eye, you can have it even like a right up against the eye, so that they touch or just barely separated. I'm gonna have mine just barely separated. Kind of the same shape. But he is, again, a little crazy, so you can make those different. I'm just gonna show what it looks like when they're the same shape. He's got these really thick, pretty simple eyebrows. They're, if you think of the C shape, and then another C shape here, similar to the mouth where it's a little closer on the sides than it is in the middle. So I'm just gonna draw that here. And these eyebrows are all black. So we can color it in. Lastly, we gotta have him looking right at us, right? So I'm gonna make him, just decided, a little cross-eyed, because he's crazy. But you could always have him looking right at us by pulling the eyes a little bit more away from the middle, but you know, it's up to you. I'm gonna start just darkening in this top part just to indicate that we wanna do that. And sometimes you wanna take a second before you finish your drawing just to take a look at it and see if everything's working the way that you thought it did. So I'm gonna step back, look at it. Cheeks a little rounder. So what we're gonna do for this drawing, probably do it a couple times this week, is color it in by and large before we do the outline parts of it, just to make sure that it doesn't smudge too much. There's one color that I'm gonna work on that really smudges, so I wanna make sure I get that in first. And that is yellow. It's funny, a lot of the Disney cats that we're drawing have different color eyes than a normal Disney character. And Cheshire Cat is no different. He's got these bright yellow eyes. So I'm gonna start coloring that in now. If I were to do the outline first, then that would probably smudge into the yellow. And since the yellow is such a light color, it'd be pretty distracting. There'd be all these weird black streaks in the middle of his eyes. I don't wanna have that. His actual eyeballs are black. Sorry, not eyeballs, the iris pupil area. So we're not gonna put a shine in there either because he's usually comes out at night. It's pretty dark. Let me get the other eye. And you can see this technique, I'll be doing it through the whole drawing. When I'm coloring in an object, I try to keep it in the same direction, the strokes that I'm doing. That way that I can keep it consistent and I don't have to make it kind of like crosshatchy. It can get a little messy if you change directions, so try to keep it consistent. And again, these are just Crayola color pencils. It really doesn't matter which ones you use, if you even want to color. Drawing should be fun, everybody. So hopefully you have not thrown away your drawing. You're going to get to appreciate it soon. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and color in his nose. I think it's this one. Yeah. So the nose is this really bright pink as compared to the other parts of him. So I'm just picking colors. This is magenta officially. Before we move on to the black line, we have some cool things I want to show you. This is another light color, so I want to try to get that in too before I put in the black line. So this is just a pink. It's going to go on the lower part of the face. Thank you. even without doing the black line, you can sort of see how the coloring in of Cheshire Cat kind of makes some of these excessive lines go away. Because the more specific we make a drawing, eventually the more the audience knows how to look at it. So the way that I always work that you've seen in all these classes is general to specific. And by that I mean I start with big general shapes and then I start defining them more and more as I go. And it's actually a pretty common technique in animation and in art. If you see even somebody doing an oil painting, they start with really broad strokes and then eventually start defining it. You very rarely start with painting a realistic eyeball and build around that. Kind of rough in a shape and then start building in more defined, confident shapes once you've made all of the choices. So I think some people might be tricked by looking at art and think that the artist knew what they were doing all the way through and just did it perfectly from the start, but I've been to a lot of exhibits where they show a lot of artists' pencil sketches to sort of get their ideas out and understand how they might execute it. And I think that's helped me a lot understand that there's a lot of work that goes into it. Okay. Also, the inside of the ears is the same color as his lower part of his face, so I just want to color that part. And that's the bigger part of the ear. The outside is going to be a different color. The last color I have is sort of, what do we call it? In this box, it's called raspberry, but it's just the darkest of the pinks that I have that I can color in the top part of his head. This is the fur and everything around the eyes. So I'm just gonna start blocking that in as well. See, it's kind of a purpley pink. Pretty sure that's the official description. If you're not really confident about being able to color in between the lines, feel like you're always going over, you can use these circles as practice for that. Again, this is our safe zone to make mistakes in, so you can kind of use this space to learn how to do a thing that you might be doing over here for the first time. My main goal for you guys is that drawing should be fun and you don't get stressed out over it. It's enough happening out there that this should be a stress-free zone. And the hairs. Eyebrows are gonna be black too, so we can sort of color over those, that'll be fine. So we're gonna go over them in a darker color. A lot of really interesting color in this film. The designs are kind of wild and the color is unexpected for a lot of things, like all of these different pinks for this character. The character is voiced by Sterling Holloway, who did a lot of voices for Disney over the years, but probably most famously, he was the original Winnie the Pooh. And he did the voice of Ka in Jungle Book. Once you hear it, you sort of can't unhear him, but he's a great voice actor. I'm going to start shading a little bit more. So once I get into the outlines later, I might decide that I want to add a little bit more depth to the color. Because again, the drawing is constantly changing and evolving as I add more to it. So a lot of times when you make a choice in a drawing and you decide it's good, it doesn't mean it's always going to be good. You might need to go back and re-evaluate. Switch it up here. And that's okay. As long as you're thinking while you're drawing, you're doing it. So. For some of the shading here. Okay, so that is our underdrawing plus some color on Cheshire Cat. Before we go into the lines, I want to show you some color examples from the film. Some great paintings done by a famous Disney designer named Mary Blair. Her style is probably most noticeable, here we go, that's better without the glare, in this film. So you can see in both these gorgeous paintings, kind of the simple shapes, deceptively simple shapes, and the muted color palette. And this crazy series. Trying to get it without the glare, here we go. So this is part of that same archive series design. Anyway, a lot of really beautiful artwork. You should look up Mary Blair. Okay, time to go in for our outlines. So I'm just gonna start on the left side of the drawing, even though I have all these things already built. Hope you guys are enjoying Cats Week. It's interesting with picking one topic and seeing how that was achieved over the years by different artists. It'll be fun to see all the different cats that we draw. Get a different black pencil, this one getting a little short. Same kind of pencil, just newer. Okay, now we can build in these eyebrows. I said before, they're black, so we can just start coloring them in. Look like him. So sharp. So when you're doing a drawing, the eyes are usually the part of the character that everyone will look at first. So I spend a little bit longer on the eyes, just want to make sure that they look right. Cheshire Cat's too one of the rare characters that even though we're just drawing the head, we can't assume his body's in there somewhere because he likes to disappear, show only half of his body, half of his head, and so, you know, it's in there. Just putting the sheet of paper down between my hand and the drawing so that I don't smudge it for these last couple things. Remember how many times we changed this nose? But can't even tell. No one will ever know. Well, you'll know because you watch me do it, but after this. Okay. just like the mouth on the Cheshire Cat is as important as the eyes. So being very careful with this part of it. While we have it. Then we have these whiskers. And the trick with whiskers too is that you don't want to do them too slowly. This should feel like hairs that get thinner as they get up to the edge. So I'm going to make sure that I'm starting from the center, pushing my pencil in and then letting go as I go out. So they don't need to fully copy the same path as the line that we drew beforehand. Looks like little shadows. Teeth lines. And the same thing as the whiskers, just quick lines. And then lastly, we want to do the eyeballs. There we go. I think we did it. I'm gonna go ahead and sign mine down here at the bottom with a brand new sharpened pencil. Let's try it again. And that's it, Cheshire Cat. Cool, well I hope you had a good time drawing him. I'm gonna clean my hands off since we just used all those tools. Be sure to share your drawing, sign it and share it. I use the hashtag drawingwithwoodsy, you can see it at the top of the page. You can share it on either Twitter or Instagram, and that's a great way to see all the other drawings, too, that happened. People all around the world are drawing at the same time, which is great. So you can check out all the different Cheshire Cats, see how the eyes are different from each other. If you tag me in your story, then I'm able to share it onto mine, and then at the end of the day, you can just click through my stories on Instagram and see all the different versions of it. So I hope you had a good time drawing, and remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. So thank you for spending your day with me. I'll see you tomorrow. Bye now.